The kitty cat has been chewing on my fucking microphone and there is like cat hair everywhere. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name's Luna, welcome. Today I am gonna be showing you guys my current everyday gothic, all whatever the fuck you wanna call it, makeup routine. So I've done a couple videos like this already, but the last one that I did was a while ago and I've since changed up the way I've been doing my makeup. This routine for me is like an everyday routine, but I will warn you, it does involve liquid eyeliner. I know that that's something that a lot of people struggle with, so I'm gonna try and show you guys some tips on how to make it easier. For me, what takes the most amount of energy in my routine is eyeshadow. So this routine does not involve a lot of eyeshadow, the blending and, you know, all that. It just takes up a lot of time. And lately I have not been in the best mental space, but you know, looking the way I want to look really does improve my mental health and it makes me feel happy. So this routine to me is really simple. I hope I can break it down and make it simple for you guys to try and recreate too. So my primer has not changed at all. I'm still using the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Soft Matte. And you know what's really sad? I had an almost empty one and a full one. And I couldn't remember which one was which because they were both kind of not coming out. So I threw one away and I think I threw the wrong one away. So now I have to repurchase this because I'm pretty sure this was the empty one. I might use another primer today. All right, well, I didn't want to change my primer, but I do still have a little bit of the Tatcha Silk Canvas left, and I feel like these are pretty similar, so we're gonna use that instead. Okay, so when I do want to keep things simple with my makeup, one of my main goals is to make my eyes look bigger. I have deep set eyes. I have a lot of space up here. Because of that, I feel like when I am not wearing makeup, my eyes just don't look as big, and that's what I want. So the first thing that I've already done is put in these enlarging contacts from Pinky Paradise, and I will link them below if I can find them. I bought them a while ago, but what you can do is just go to their page, and they have a whole section on their page for enlarging contact. Foundation, I'm still using the ColourPop Pretty Fresh. For concealer, I'm using the Anastasia Concealer, the Magic Touch. This is shade 1. For brows, I'm still using the Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in shade Granite. And I do have this little brow slit now, so I'll show you how I've been doing that. It's pretty easy. So when I do this, I use this brush. I think this is, yeah, this is number 15. This is my favorite eyebrow brush. I'll probably never switch this. And I just kind of scrape the pomade onto the side like that. So when I do my brows, I always start on the bottom. We're gonna outline first and then fill it in. All right, so we got our first line, and then we're basically gonna do the same thing on the top, but I'm not gonna take it all the way in. I'm gonna start kind of where my brow starts to naturally get thicker, which is about right here. Now we're gonna fill it in, starting from the outside and working our way in. Okay, so for the brow slit side, I'll try and film this for you. I always film the right side of my face because I just, with being right-handed, this is easier for me. But as you can see, I started my line and then stopped right here. So we're gonna skip our little slit and finish it off on this side. So as you can see, this side is a little messy. So what we're gonna do is clean that up with concealer. I usually use the Tarte Shape Tape to do this part because I feel like it just dries down a little cleaner. I'm out of it right now. So I am just gonna go ahead and use my concealer that I already used. This concealer is very thick, so I feel like it's easier to fuck this up, but I'm out of it, so there's really nothing I can do. I usually just do the lower layer. I try not to do the upper side if I don't have to. Okay, now for the slit, instead of kind of like doing this with my brush, I'm going to go like this, just straight on carefully. We will tap like that. For the concealer on this side, I kind of just blend the top of it. I try not to touch the actual slit. So moving on to eyes. So this is the ABH eye primer. It's my favorite. Okay, hey, real quick, before you do anything, I totally forgot to mention this. If you do struggle with eyeliner and getting it even, before you do eyeshadow, before you do anything else, I highly recommend the e.l.f. I think they're called eye tapes, and they're super, super helpful. You can place them first in the shape you want your eyeliner to go, make sure they're even, and it'll make eyeliner a lot easier. So that's my first tip for helping with liquid eyeliner. Okay, now with my fluffy brush and the ColourPop Blow and Smoke palette, I am just going to smear this shade up here, Stone Face, all over my lid. Now I'm going to take shade Ignite, which is the one right under here, and I'm just gonna kind of concentrate this in the outer kind of triangle area. Before we move on to eyeliner, I'm gonna just go ahead and do the eyeshadow underneath my eyes as well. So taking Stone Face again. I'm just gonna put that all over the place. And then I'm gonna do the same with Ignite. Same brush too. And then one last step before we move on to eyeliner. I'm taking my Makeup Revolution Highlighter Reloaded. And I'm just going to pop a little bit of that in my inner corner. I fucking love this highlighter. It's a really good dupe for the Fenty Diamond Balm. Okay, guys, it is eyeliner time. Make sure that your elbow is resting on a hard surface. I used to do my makeup either on my bathroom counter, like I would sit in the sink so I could be close enough to the mirror because I'm blind as fuck, or when I had a floor mirror, I would do my makeup on the floor and just like get really close. But now that I have a vanity, I've realized it's so much easier to rest your elbow on something. If you can find a way to do that, whether it's on your desk or your bathroom counter, resting your elbow if you have shaky hands like I do is really, really helpful. I like to do my first two lines first because it's a lot easier to fix your eyeliner if you do that, like if they're uneven. So I'm gonna draw my first two lines, and this is the Essence Super Precise Liquid Eyeliner. It's my fave. When I do eyeliner, I kind of aim for the outer corners of my eyebrows. And then since I have smaller eyelids, I try and put most of my eyeliner on the outside. I really don't want to cover up my eyelids. So I always start kind of in the middle and just connect this line. After you have this, I'm gonna draw a very thin line for my inner corner. Also, if you're curious about my sweatshirt, super cute. Me and my boyfriend actually acquired an anime retail hobby store in downtown Portland. It was really kind of last minute. He was looking for jobs because he really didn't like his job. And we saw that somebody was selling their business. It's this cute little store in downtown Portland. So if you're local to Portland, Oregon, definitely come visit us. I'm there sometimes, not all the time because I have a lot of shit to do. I love the apparel that is at the store. We're a little low on inventory right now. waiting on more. A lot of the stuff we have is from Japan, and just with COVID and shipping stuff, it's taken a while to get more. I always put on my Instagram story when I'm there. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, you totally should, and you should follow the business Instagram too, so you can see updates for when we get more stuff. So once this is dry, the thing I really like to do to open up my eyes and make them look bigger is to draw a little swoop like that. And I was inspired to start doing that because I really like how cut creases look on me, but they take a long fucking time. So I just started kind of outlining where I would put a cut crease, and I really love how it looks. So I like to make it bigger on the outside. It really puts to use all this like fucking space that I have. And then next I'm gonna draw another wing. And then last but not least, I promise you guys, the last little eyeliner thing is inner corner liner. Inner corner liner is still really hard for me. I'm still practicing, so don't feel bad if you can't do it. It also doesn't fit everybody's face. If your eyes are naturally more close together on your face, you might not like how this looks on you, but experiment and try it, because I always thought it would look bad on me, and then when I tried it, I actually loved it, and I've never gone back. Okay, I lied to you again. There's one more eyeliner thing, but it's not liquid. I just like to do a wet pencil eyeliner for my waterline. And I still have not found a good cruelty-free option. This is the Sephora Collection Glide Liner. I really like it. I have yet to find something that's this good. I never do my makeup without doing lashes. These are from Rouge and Rouge, like always. And I don't remember what these are called. I think these are Electra. For glue, I use the Black Duo glue. I like the one where you squeeze it out more than the brush-on one, because I feel like that one just does not give you enough product. While I'm letting that set, I'm going to do a little bit of contour, not a lot. And I actually like doing my contour with gray eyeshadow. So I'm gonna use this little Marc Jacobs pod that I have. This one is Memento, but you can use any gray eyeshadow you want. You just want a little slanted brush like this. See, this looks good with my skin tone. I don't think this would look good on everybody. I just really don't like the way that like even cool tone contour looks on me sometimes. Like it always looks very warm, even if it's advertised as cool. So especially when I'm doing these like darker looks, I like to use just like a gray eyeshadow. And then I'm gonna use that same highlighter as before. So I'm just taking my lash by the middle, I'm gonna tilt my head back, and I'm just gonna drop it right on my lash line. So where do you let go? It should just stick. That's how you know you did it right. And then you can push the corners in. So before I blend in these lashes with mascara, I'm just gonna let the glue completely dry. And this might even be the reason you clicked on this video. I'm gonna show you guys my new fave black lipstick. So don't get me wrong, the Black Moon Cosmetics lipstick is like my one true love. But if you struggle with liquid lipstick because it's really dry, you have to try this one. So this is the Ofra, I think I'm saying that correctly, Ofra Cosmetics. This is called Bronx. I was looking for black lipsticks that I hadn't tried before, and I came across this one. And oh my God, this is the most hydrating liquid lipstick I think I have ever tried. It is fucking amazing. It has kind of a mousse consistency, but when you put it on, it's still pretty thin, and it's like hydrating. I don't know how the fuck they did that. I have never had a liquid lipstick formula like this. I'm gonna have to buy all of their lipsticks. It's pretty impressive. I love this thicker consistency because unlike thinner watery liquid lipsticks, which they tend to bleed more, and this one does not. And I feel like it's really easy to get the outside border super crisp and even. So I feel like this is a really great beginner friendly liquid lipstick. So I overline my lips, clearly. I like the way that looks on me. You don't have to do that. The thing about this lipstick, it will transfer a bit easier than a true matte liquid lipstick. And that's kind of the trade-off. More hydration equals more transferness. But I think it's a good trade-off because this feels so comfortable. Okay, I'm just gonna do a little mascara just to blend my lashes in, and then we're done. One last little step, and we are all done. I think it's super cute. Let me know what you think in the comments and if you tried this look and how it went for you. And yeah, we're all done. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.